So Terrell, you're holding a baseball bat and I'm holding a baseball. Why exactly are we doing this today?
Hey, so Johnny, what we're going to talk about is the similarities between batting in baseball and kicking a soccer ball. Okay, so when we look at batting in baseball and we compare that to soccer, I'm just going to show something and bring it back to how the brain processes information. So Johnny's going to pretend to be our pitcher, an amazing pitcher I have here, just absolutely amazing technique. And I'm going to be using my children's lovely Paw Patrol bat in order to provide you some information on how exactly this works. So if I'm sitting in the old batter's box and I'm going to be trying to bat and hit the ball that Johnny's pitching against me, first, I need to be able to use anticipatory mechanisms to look at his body, to look at the visual cues that he's showing off in order to try to understand what it is that he's going to do when he transfers the ball from the pitcher's mound to where I am in the batter's box. Now, here's the key. As I'm about to now bat and try to hit the ball as it's in time and space, one of the biggest pieces is that the speed in which a batter now moves the bat. So the quicker that I'm able to move the bat in time and space, I actually am able to process more information. So if I bat slower, then that means that I have less time. So the less time that the ball is released from the pitcher to where I am in the batter's box, there's less time for me to process. So if, for example, the pitcher throws a slider or a curveball, I'm not going to get as much feedback. My brain's not going to process as much information unless I now speed up the velocity in which I now take the bat and move it against the ball. And I now can take in more information. The ball can travel further. So I now am able to take more cues, process more in my brain, where that ball is in time and space, wait longer. And now by taking the bat and moving it faster, I now have much, much more success. And now we're going to show you how that now transfers to soccer. Okay, so now we're going to take our baseball example we just gave a second ago, and we're going to let the baseball go, and we're now going to pretend that that baseball is Coach John's leg. Now, in the academy, what we do is we talk a lot about how the body is formed. So we talk about the par position. We talk about being loaded. We talk about our midline. We talk about how we accelerate, how we decelerate, where we put our weight, how we put the load on our feet, how the foot touches the ball. All of this stuff we incorporate as part of our curriculum. Now, something we're going to show real quick. John's going to give us two different types of ball distribution techniques that could be used. So we're just going to quickly show the difference between how exactly when you're playing at higher levels, you're transitioning to higher levels, the brain is going to be able to help you transition to higher levels easier. So the first thing John's going to do, he's going to give us what we call the delayed kicking technique. So John's going to quickly show us a delayed kicking technique. So notice how in the delayed, he's overemphasizing this a little bit for the sake of the video, but notice how John is delaying his foot. So after he contacts the ball, he's leaving his foot hanging, and the ball is already hitting the target position before he actually brings his foot back down. Now what John's going to do is he's going to reset, and he's actually going to give us a more direct and specific contact on the balls. Is again a technique that we look to work on within the academy, and now we're going to talk about the quick difference. So John's going to give us a couple of demos. Okay, so notice how the difference when John is contacting the ball in the second technique, immediately the second that John is contacting the ball, he's now putting his foot back down on the ground. So as soon as he plays, he's now resetting his body. He's getting back into that power position as quick as possible. That's perfect, Coach John. So now, when we look at Coach John's, the difference between the first technique and the difference between the second technique is that just like in the batting example, the quicker that John is able to contact the ball, looking at his visual cues within his environment and actually get back into that power position as quick as possible, he gets more information within his environment. He's able to now see where exactly the secondary action or potentially a third action is going to be depending on the cues that are provided by the ball and with the environment itself. So if John's back into his power position as quickly as possible, no matter where the ball now goes and we're into our loaded stance, we now have the ability to now transition any direction that we want to go. So just like the batting example, the quicker we can swing the bat, the more information we're going to get on where the ball is going. The quicker Coach John can contact the ball and get back into his power position, he's now in a much better position physically and also cognitively to be able to now transition into any direction that he wants to go. We're going to show you one more quick tip, just to final up with this, finishing up this video, to be able to show you also why it is you want that secondary technique that Coach John was showing when you contact the ball. Okay, so the final part of this video, we're just going to show you something real quick. Now, what Coach John is going to do, he's going to show he snaps the ball like we were showing previously and how the ball is going to come right back to him, and he's getting to that power position really, really quickly so he can adjust and respond to the ball accordingly. Perfect. Well done, Coach John. So as you can see, Coach John, Amelia, second he played the ball, he's back into his power position. No matter where the ball was going to go, he's now prepared to adjust accordingly. Resetting his feet, great job, Coach John. Okay, so now what we're going to watch is Coach John is going to play that secondary technique where when he plays the ball, he leaves his foot out longer. And again, there's two things that happen here. One, by leaving your foot out longer, not getting back into that power position as quickly as possible, you have less time in order to process what's going on in your environment in order to adjust accordingly. The second thing is we're also going to see a change in how the ball responds and reacts off of the specific target position. So we're going to watch Coach John, and then I'll talk about it in a second. Okay, good. Now, what you saw when Coach John now played that, as he delayed his foot, again, not only could he not get back into the power position quickly, we now saw this bounce. So when we have players that are playing one touch, we have situations in a game, you know, we're playing 4v4, we get some sort of game with outputs and teams, and players are doing a quick 1-2 or a quick engagement or interaction, and now all of a sudden we see a bounce effect. One, it's because the players held out their foot too long. When they hold their foot too long out in space, the cue recognition by the teammates is now off because now you're not able to transition as quickly as possible based on the cues of your teammate. The player who's actually kicking the ball can't transition fast enough if there's a change within the environment. Let's say there's transition, you're going the opposite way, you're not in power position, you can't respond and react. And we're now seeing that because we've delayed our foot longer, the actual studs on the boot get caught on the top of the ball. And it's not a nice clean kick. It's not a nice clean technique. And you now see this bounce effect. So a couple of pieces of advice. One, get back in your power position as quickly as possible so they're able to respond and react to your cues faster. And also your distribution is much, much cleaner. Thank you for watching the PGYSA Impact Extra Time Kickoff. We're looking forward to seeing you on future videos.